billed as the March for Justice, thousands marched towards Scotland Yard in protest of deaths in police custody. The march was sparked by the death of Smiley Culture, a popular reggae artist who police say killed himself while they raided his house. Dissatisfied with the police version of events, the people took to the streets. We went down to Scotland Yard to capture their reaction to the situation. Okay, first things first, what brings you to today's march?
Well, basically, we're just solidarity for Smiley Culture, basically, because growing up, he was one of the icons that I looked up to, you know? Well, I had to come. I've been demonstrating since 1958. After growing up in Ladbrokes, Nutnell Gate, where the first race riot started, I personally have been documenting, and I couldn't miss this one.
Okay, first things first, what brings you to today's march?
Demand for justice.
Yep, exactly, I'll echo that. Demand for justice to make our voices stand in unity and support for Smiley Culture's family and all those other families who have been treated to the injustices of the judicial system in the UK.
It's a public event, it's something for the community. It's really just to say that we are united regardless of what people might think. And it's an unexplained death. It's an unexplained death. That's what's brought me here, really.
Because I love Smiley and I love his music and I love to be around him and to meet people and to meet what I'm dealing with as well.
Certainly I'm aware for some time about the death in police custody. And it was something I was concerned about, so a lot of colleagues. And I think the least I could do is to come along, you know, and join with the folks and see what we can support that we can give.
What brings you to today's event?
A lot of my friends were arrested at the March 26th protests at Thornwell Masons. Someone wrote a blog on the internet about how it'd be really good for people to show solidarity with other people who've been the victim of police violence. I've been the victim of police violence myself, to come out, show the solidarity to Smiley Culture and what happened to all people who've died under police custody and have suffered at the hands of the police.
As a disc jockey and as a man who, as I say, the media look up to, or I mean the media, the eyes of the media, I'm needed to be here. And justice, enough is enough now, you know? So justice has to prevail. So I'm here to do everything.
You heard the official police story that, you know, they let him make a cup of tea and that he stabbed himself. Do you believe that story?
Well, I weren't there, so I can't say I don't believe it. But I know if the police raid your house, they put you in handcuffs, and they hold you down and they look through your house what they want, the chance of you being able to make a cup of tea is, why would they? Why would they? So, you know, I weren't there, but it's a dodgy sounding story.
We don't believe that story. We've never even properly heard the police story. We've not heard it on the news. We've not really properly read it in the newspaper. So we haven't actually really heard a full and serious version of the police story. In any case, what we have so far heard sounds like a load of rubbish to us.
In this particular scenario, have you heard the official police story that he actually, you know, he killed himself, he was making a cup of tea and he killed himself? Do you believe that story?
Yeah, not for a moment. It's the kind of bullshit they always say. They did it with Ian Tomlinson at the G20. Like, I was there and, like, the first thing that we heard is them saying, oh, the police were trying to help him, trying to, like, get him better, but activists were throwing bottles at the police. It's like, like, they always come up with this stuff. They send out the press releases about what they want us to believe, like, before anyone knows anything. And, like, 2 days later, everyone's always going, well, that doesn't make any sense. No, don't believe it for a moment.
So, I was a bad youth. I had one of the first girl gangs in London, okay. Ladbroke Grove and all that. So, I know for a fact that if the police used to come in my house to raid me, they wouldn't let me move. You'd be stuck to the city. You wouldn't be allowed to make a cup of tea because you can throw boiling water at police. You're near a knife. So that's one of the first things the police are taught in a house raid.
Have you heard the police story about what happened in terms of, you know, they say that they let him go and get some tea?
Yeah,
and
sure,
What did you think of that story?
Well, it's all washed, you know what I mean? There's a lot of inconsistency with the stories, but, you know, I'm not a professional in that respect. I'm just, as a listener and someone who's got sense, it doesn't make sense, so.
Knowing him personally then, do you believe that he would, you know, go and take his own life?
Nah. Listen, we're soldiers. If push comes to shove, you sit down and do your time in Wandsworth Scrubs prison. Yeah, and everyone in there would like him. If you're on your line in Scrubs, sit down, you soon get out.
understand that. But now, in the last 11 years, 338 people have died in police custody. How does that make you feel, considering it's the police who are supposed to be protecting all of us?
Very angry.
And constantly violated. It means we cannot trust the police. We cannot believe that there is a fairness in the system that is supposed to protect us. We cannot abide by it. It makes us anxious and worried about our youngsters, my nephews, my nieces, her children. Very anxious about their future in this country.
It makes me feel scared. I'm not just scared of what could happen on the street. I'm scared of those supposed to be protecting us. You don't feel safe, left or right.
Yeah. Okay. In the last 11 years now, 338 people have died in police custody. How does that make you feel, knowing that it's the police that, you know, are entrusted with our safety?
Angry, sad. One of the reasons I've come out to protest today.
Whether I believe it or not, this story sounds incredible, and that has to be looked at, because it's not a usual thing for our people to kill themselves. That's the first thing. And normally when you make an arrest, you do not let the suspect go off and do things. You're constantly in touch with them. So something is not right.
Well, they want to stop youth crime, yeah? I said something in a police town hall meeting. Deal with us first. Calm us down first. I feel to go and be like a youth again. To be honest, if I didn't have a certain self-control, I would just go out and be like a youth. And I would be like the youth are now, I wouldn't care.
Okay, and what can we do as a community to prevent this from happening again and again and again?
Things like this, unifying in support of other families, exactly, set up our own kind of organisation where we can tackle these things head on whilst they happen and be aware of what's going on, because there's been a recent one and we don't know about the recent one, the details of that. This is a continuous occurrence that we need to be aware of, and the thing that we need to do is just to mobilise, do rallies like this, support rallies like this, petition, constantly petition, right, left.
As a community, we need to all stand together, pull together, bring in everybody behind us and say enough is enough now.
Well, get things going in each area. Each person in each area needs to get campaigns going. Link all the campaigns up and come with us, because once a year we have No Deaths in Police Custody March anyway.
Okay, just finally, how do you think the march has gone?
It's extraordinary, absolutely amazing march. I've been on loads of marches. I've never been on a march with a vibe like this. Like,
the march was good. It was a serious crowd, you know what I mean? It's to make people know that we mean business and we want to get to the truth.
I thought it was actually amazing. There was a bigger turnout than I thought, because we didn't get much press coverage. Like, BBC wasn't taking in notice, things like that. So, and we really Facebook campaigned it and things like this. So I didn't think there'd be as many people, but when I look back and we turn the corner and everybody kept the peace.
You know what, it's going good. I don't know how many people there, but there's a lot of people there, and boy, this is good to see, man. And I'm glad to be a part of this, man.
But it was lovely, you know what I mean? From what I've heard, it was nice. And obviously, it's been peaceful, and it could have not been, because obviously tensions and passions are running high, so, you know.
Very peaceful. It's like a carnival atmosphere. And this is what we're about as a people. You see the other riots where people are smashing up places. We don't have to do that. We get a message across, and hopefully we all go home in peace.
Finally, how do you think the march has gone? You know, there's a lot of people here. How do you think it's gone? Do you think it's been a success?
I think it's been very much a success. And I think that's good. Good to see the solidarity. Good to see people turn out. And brilliant. Even young kids. People who might not even have known Smiley Culture, you know, young kids are here, and I think that's brilliant. A really good day, and I'm glad that I came.
So the march was a success, and the police have launched an investigation into Smiley Culture's death. Whether or not this will shed any light on the situation remains to be seen. However, what is certain is that the public have grown weary of the ongoing injustice.